Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. We need to get a sample of infected tissue for Ruben to study. Unfortunately, we can't really do that ourselves because local customs prohibit it. However, the butchers are allowed to actually cut open bodies and take samples and stuff like that. So we need to see if we can enlist the help of the butchers. So we've come here to this person's home, which we've been to one time before. Apparently, runaway butchers often come here for protection. And let's see if we can get the help of the butchers. Also, hello. Can I get a bandage from you? Aw, you're empty. No water for you.
Pins are sticking out of the pores of my skin.
Ugh. Please touch me. Do I have a fever? How about I don't touch you? You do. I can feel it from here.
Is it really that deadly? Yes, it is.
Do you know anything about how the disease is transmitted? I know everything. Everything in the world? The infection goes straight to the head. It talks to you a bit with this little inner voice, and then it moves in completely. For a while. The tenant is rather troublesome, and the body makes for a lousy lodging. It breaks apart all too easily. And so the disease leaves it and moves along to find someone else. Moves in? What do you mean? It listens to your thoughts, peeks inside you, takes a nice look, and moves in. But the check-in only happens after a very short and crucial interview. It'll only move in if it fancies you. Otherwise, you may keep on with your plain, boring life. But making it fancy you is easy. It doesn't really discriminate, as you can see. Did it speak to you too? I think it did. It's just that I was unlucky. My condolences.
Shabnakadir is tracing the streets like bacteria in a vein.
You are concealing runaway butchers in this very house. Aspati? I'm not really sure how to say her name. Well, crucify me. What's this about? Running more errands for the old Gimskis? No. This time I've come on my own accord. I need your help. Well, I gotta hear that. Why on earth would the wise serpent seek anyone's help? I need the tissue of a sand plague victim. You can only find dead victims in the infected houses. Since you appear to be alive, you have never entered a single one of them. You'll have 5 to 10 minutes if you do. Then the infections strike, with the expected results. Perhaps you could find a single runaway that would agree to help. What would he want in return? Perhaps I could find a lot of runaways that would agree to help, if only I ask them to. And the same me will ask you for a favor then. Will you do me one? I will. Go ahead and speak. You're influential with Olgimsky. Use that influence. Tell him to stop persecuting the runaways. It's no longer a revenge situation. But he's still all too eager. Takes the guy quite some time to calm down, huh? Anyway, if he swears to leave alone the butchers that are now outside the termitary, I'll talk 3 runaways into risking their lives. It's not like they have anything to lose anyway. I'll try. Okay, we have our quest. Back to the old Gimskis. I feel like I should go to the cemetery for some reason. I don't really know why. But I'm gonna go there. Let's go visit Grace. It's been a while since we've seen her. And it's pretty close by. I feel like this big ditch is gonna be filled with bodies at some point soon. I've got to sleep pretty soon.
Is the disease really this contagious?
Don't you dare touch the dead. Leave now. Have you gone mental? What would I want with your dead? They said a scary doctor will be making the rounds today, turning the dead inside out, even though he has no right to. It sounded like you. I think I have some idea who that might be. No, that doctor isn't me. I guess there isn't anything really to do with Grace. Not yet. Okay, to the old Gimskis. Just follow the train tracks for now. Seems like the quickest way. Going through the machinery now. All the factories with groaning noises coming from within. What if there's something in here? Bah. Yeah, I can hear all the cattle. Do I have any reason to stop by young Vlad's place? I suppose I can see if I can tell him about Simon's body. I don't know if I really have a reason to, but I already tried to tell Reuben, and he didn't seem to care. It probably is the Canes that I'm supposed to take the information to. But again, that doesn't really fit with what Reuben was saying about wanting first dibs on the body, and how he didn't want the Canes to know about it. But young Vlad is not a Cane. So, perhaps... Wait, can I not even speak with you?
Oh, there we go. Interest speaks all sorts of tongue.
Some very peculiar attitudes about the dead in your town. Yes, they're derived from pagan superstition. The body is considered to be the sum of all truths. The ligaments, keeping it whole. To be the ligaments of the universe. It must not be taken apart without the knowledge of how those dissection cuts will reverberate in the makeup of the universe. And you share in that superstition? A body is a self-contained system. Sometimes it's fascinating to take note of how ingenious its natural design is. Not a single useless part. Even atavisms, such as the coccyx, serve to add certain charm. Everything is in harmony. But the system is easily disrupted. Yes, when an alien object interferes, like a bullet, a knife, or a foreign organism, is it true what they say about microbes being sentient? Age kills a person even in a perfect environment. I've devoted my professional fortunes to this regrettable fact. Simon has proven otherwise. The Canes used that as a foundation for a new era. Incidentally, I don't understand what Georgie's frustration. Wait, I don't underst- I think this was to say, I don't understand what George's frustration is. What does it matter if Simon was undone by a murderer's blade or by an infectious filth? Both things are equally foreign interferences. Unless, of course, the microbe originated inside Simon. Who knows what methods the Keeper employed to reach those impressive results? They could have scary side effects. Oh, the methods were purely spiritual. There's no doubt about that. I'm a skeptic, but Simon is a special case. Alright. Far be it from me to try to change your mind. To the Olgimskis, and I'm kind of going the wrong way. Shotgun shells? No thanks. Yeah, maybe I should get a bandage from this guy, but what they said about the water supply being cut short and how the town's gonna run out of water, it makes me think I should save my water bottles in case they are more valuable later on. So I think I'm actually gonna do that because I don't need any bandages right now. Ooh. Meridorm and some more. Oh, right, I have nothing to trade with her. Dang. Ah, hello. I will take all of that. Pretty late. 7 p.m. Oh god, this is Town Hall. I went past the Olgimskis, oh my god! I was too caught up in trading and searching bins. I'm doomed. Nah, it'll be fine. Don't worry about it. There's nothing to worry about in this world, right? It's so calming. So wonderful. Here, kid, take the sharp object in exchange for a bullet. I mean, a round, sorry. There's nothing wrong with this world, everything's fine. Hey, don't run with that sharp thing, okay?
Many a mickle makes a muckle. There's no hurry.
I'd like to offer you a bargain. It has to do with your fugitives. Oh, come now. To my mind, there's nothing to discuss here. However, a good bargain always catches my attention. So... Let's try to be a shrewd businessman here. Can you donate your runaways to me? I can guarantee that they'll die in the end. Aren't you a humanitarian, my dear doctor? Thing is, I don't need them to die. I need them to return to the bosom of the Bull Project. Punished, but unscathed. Oh my god, his eyes look so crazy right now. Look at that. You must have already noticed that anyone's chances to escape the epidemic unscathed are rather low. I can increase theirs. What's in this for you? Do I tell him what I want them for? Or do I try to hide it? I don't want to tell him what it's for. I have my own job to do, and I need these people. As for now, sadly, I cannot disclose to you as to why. And what would you be willing to offer? I'm ready to hear your offer. Let me see. I know what I'm going to ask as a payment for my butchers. It's the unique resource you own, the one I'll never get my hands on. What is it? Your influence with the Canes. I'll cease to pursue the butchers if Georgie ceases to pursue young Barak. He isn't guilty. He has an airtight alibi against all charges, which I'm willing to confirm. Let them leave him alone. Agreed. Young Barak, that's right. A lot of people suspected that Isidore's son, who came to town apparently right around the time of Isidore's death, is actually the one who killed him, right? Why do you care for Isidore's son so much? We have a common goal. I see. So you're saying he's completely innocent, right? Indeed, indeed. And I'd rather you convinced Reuben that young Barak has nothing to do with Isidore's tragic death. The thick-headed Reuben is the last one who still needs convincing anyway. The boy might be labeled a patricide, as if he hasn't had enough. You do see Reuben from time to time, I know that. Right. Yeah, I'd rather you avoided telling around that I know where Reuben is. That's true, because Reuben doesn't want the Canes to know where he is, right? And I'd rather you avoided telling around that I know where Reuben is. I haven't finished yet. Apart from that, I wish they stopped torturing me about the termitary. I'm tired of repeating that it's clean. That is why it was closed in the first place. This is a big decision. This one happened before I closely examined the termitary myself, so unfortunately we are unlikely to find a compromise. Wow, tell him to F off? Or what? But I feel like I need his cooperation, right? Like, I kinda need these people to get the tissue samples, do I not? If they don't, what the hell am I supposed to do? If I go in there on my own... My god, if I go against such a strong local custom... If anyone finds out, they are going to hate me. But I really, really want to see inside the termitary myself. Fine. I'm gonna do it. You know what? You've just suggested an excellent idea to me. How about this? You stop the persecution. And I'll kindly spare the Canes my opinion on what's inside the termitary. Or termerary, rather. Have I been pronouncing it termitary the whole time? Termerary? I don't even know. For goodness sake, if you put it like this... Yes, certainly. Certainly. I was going to... as well... It's no matter now. Now that the Skinners are infected... Just like the crude sprawl before it. You have my word as a merchant. The thing is, I know you as a man of honor. Damn it. I feel like I'm getting too dirty here. Like I'm going in too deep. Do keep in mind that you've given yourself away more than I could have ever expected.
This girl is dangerous. Very dangerous. No one can resist her.
I need to sleep super bad. Can I sleep in your bed, sir? I can. As awkward as that is, I think I need to. So I'm gonna take some drugs, and I'm gonna sleep for an hour. It's okay. Everything will be fine. I hope. Jesus. How's my infection doing? Not bad. My immunity's gone down a bit. There. A couple more doses of the yellow pills. Okay, I really don't have that much time left. So I need to go to the Canes, right? Right? Do I need to go to the Canes? Let's check and make sure. Well, Gimski has become strangely pliable. Apparently, he is most troubled by the termitary. Oh, it is termitary. It was just misspelled before. It has become a kind of Achilles heel to him. It is interesting to note that he asked me to solicit for young Barak, as he stands accused before the Canes. Could it be that something is wrong here? Well, yes, obviously. I guess we do have to go to the Canes. Let's go. No time to spare. Only about about 3.5 hours left in the day. And now that I think about it, I suppose I didn't have to sleep. I do have some lemons I could eat, and those reduce my exhaustion, but they also increase my hunger, and I'm not really willing to do that. Actually, there's no letters I've missed. Nope. All cut up. Where am I going? Kind of the wrong way. I'm not that far off track. I'm trying to see how well I could navigate this city without using the map. In fact, even though this is a terrible time to do it, I'm gonna see if I can get all the way to the Canes without looking at the map a single additional time. This way. Up the stairs, and I think if I take a right, there'll be the bridge. Yeah, I'm a navigational expert. More medicine. Yes. As much as possible, please. You know, I feel like I need the yellow pills more than Maridorm. Again, I don't have anything small enough to barter with without wasting it. Yeah, here we go. This is the Canes residence.
That does it. I'm going to break.
Guess we got to speak to Georgie. Also, since it's nighttime, we gotta be on the lookout for robbers.
Who could have thought? A plague is staring us in the face. That's how much his demise means.
I will richly reward a friend that finds Simon's body for me. And I will squeeze the last drop of blood from the mongrel who stole it. Oh my god. I can say that it was stolen by Reuben. No. I'm not gonna tell him. Yeah, I can say it was stolen by Reuben. Or that it was stolen by the butchers. I'm not gonna tell him. No. I have a favor to ask of you, Judge. I'm indebted to you, dear doctor. Speak. I will be happy to grant any request that is within my power to fulfill. It has to do with Isidore Brock's son. Yes, I know the man, if only by what the others have to say about him. Regrettably, I've yet to meet him personally. He was one of the main suspects in Simon's murder. He also hasn't cleared himself, not to my judgment anyway, of the charge of murdering his own father. Now he's the main suspect in the theft of my brother's body. I hope you're not going to solicit forgiveness on his behalf. I don't want to do this. I just don't know what choice I have. Do I have to play this game? This stupid freaking game between the three ruling powers? I guess this particular game is between two of the ruling powers, the Olgimskys and the Kanes. Do I have to play this? Do I have to do this? What the hell else can I do? Just break into one of those houses and take some flesh? As a sample? On my own? Because then I don't need the butcher's help? Which means I don't need to do any of this. If I just get the damn sample myself. But that's so freaking dangerous. I'm gonna do it. Let's get in even deeper. Here we go. That is exactly what I'm going to do. This is one of the few requests that I'm not prepared to meet. That is to say, I wouldn't be if anyone other than you were asking. But I believe without a shadow of doubt that you're acting in good faith and with most noble intentions. Vlad Olgimsky vouches for his honesty and is prepared to be a witness for him on all the charges you brought against him. So it was Olgimsky who asked you to intervene. Don't trust him, Doctor. Don't trust him. Olgimsky has many qualities worthy of respect, but being honorable is not one of them. His honor ends where his avarice begins. If he is prepared to vouch for something, it is a clear indication that he is going to profit from it. I agree with you. I'll keep that in mind, Judge. Wait, where does that leave me?
I'm deadly tired.
Stop dinging!
Who could have...
Stop dinging! It's gonna happen every time. Oh, it finally stopped. Okay, so where the hell does that leave me? Like, really, where does that leave me? I don't have to tell him about Simon's body, right? But I can't tell Reuben about where Simon's body is, which is so bizarre. Or at least I can't tell Reuben where Simon's body might be. We don't actually know if it's Simon. I feel like I'm missing something. I honestly don't know what to do now. I mean, I could tell the Kanes about Simon's body. That's like the only clear avenue where I can actually do something, but I don't want to do that. Can I do something else? I'm actually gonna have to stop here and think about this. I really don't know what to do. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm very confused, but it seems like I've actually managed to achieve more than I thought. You see, when I mouse over this, which is where I need to speak to that woman about getting the butcher's help, it says Olgimsky has agreed to stop the harassment. I hope his word is enough for the keeper of that den. Wait, I thought Olgimsky didn't agree to actually stop the harassment unless I was able to convince the Canes to not go into the termitary, or rather to stop persecuting Isidore's son, young Barak. And I didn't do that, did I? But apparently he did agree? When? I must have missed something, but yeah, apparently we've actually done what we needed to do, so let's go all the way to the other side of town. Which is pretty creepy if you think about it, because now it's dark and there's not much time, and yeah, wow, there's really not much time. Oh boy. No time to dawdle. Yeah, let's stick on the outskirts of town and go through the train tracks. I think that's the fastest way. I can't believe how long everything's taken today. I haven't, like, really dawdled at all. I've barely spent time just going around. Like, I've basically spent no time just randomly exploring. Almost everything I've been doing has been strictly quest stuff, and still, I'm almost out of time. I'm not even gonna stop at containers unless they're, like, right along the way. Also keep a lookout for robbers still, of course. Ooh, I just found something I can trade with. It's like a bangle or something.
What?
Big Vlad agrees. He swore that from this point on, not a single runaway in the town would be killed on his orders. Proof? Am I just lying if I say this? I don't actually know, but let's go with it. It's already done. The orders have been issued for Suvorov's patrolmen and the Olginsky's men, sealed and delivered. Fine, then. I'll send 3 butchers to the infected Skinners. They'll be waiting for you there. If they manage to find a dead body, cut it, and survive to see you, that is. Follow them in an hour. They may die before you reach them, so waste no time. It would make sense for me to go with them straight away, then, wouldn't it? Only the Shabnak cut the dead open. And does it even matter whose hand holds the knife? What matters is who's given out the order. Or do you think people won't realize who's violating the dead if you simply keep quiet and stand to the side? Okay, so she's thinking that people would suspect me if I came with them, which she's absolutely right. Sounds convincing. I strongly advise you to conduct reconnaissance before you go to the infected district. Prepare for the field trip, Will. Rumor has it, the place leaves you less chances than a mincing machine would. The patrolmen guarding the infected houses have already consumed half the confiscated drugs. Thank you. Do I actually have to wait an hour? Because I really don't have much time. I've got 2 hours until the end of the day. I mean, it doesn't even mention the hour here. It just says there's no time to procrastinate. So, let's go. Just waste no time. And where are they going to be waiting for me there, I wonder? Hope I don't have to search too long for them. I wouldn't mind buying some food before- Oh, shit, there's a fight. It's one of the guards, actually. Punching- what is that, an infected? They just killed them. As sick as it sounds, I wonder if I can loot the- Oh, shit, that's a huge fucking rat! Is the thing gonna attack me? Oh! Yep. Guards! Guards? So the guards punch people, but not rats, huh? That is a lockpick, dang it. Ah, fuck! Fucking hell. I was trying to save on ammo. God, that was not worth it. Hey! Is that a dog? I think that was a dog. That's the first time I've ever actually seen a dog. I've heard them, but never seen them. How's my infection? That's still not horrible, but shit. My immunity seems low, too. Let's take a couple. Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa! The hell is that? The fuck? The body still there? Nope. Yeah, food's still relatively cheap. I think I should go for it. What do I sell? Some more medicine? Sure. Who needs medicine, right? Ah, let's make a permasave. Jesus Christ. I am keeping my gun out. Looking for the butchers. Looking for the butchers. Oh yeah, what about this thing, by the way? My little plague finder. Is it supposed to show me anything, I wonder? Oh. Oh! Wow, okay. I should definitely use it then. I guess if I walk through that, I would get the plague. Ugh. Oh, they like to come towards you, huh? Shamble on over. Fuck. Where are the butchers? I'm gonna go around. More shamblers. What about the store? This store's in an infected place. Are they actually... They're still operating. Okay. That's... weird. No thanks. Just... business like normal. What is that sound? It's like a wet, squishy sound. There it is again. Where are the damn butchers? Fuck. I don't like being in here. She did say wait an hour. Maybe I do actually have to wait. Oh great, there's a robber over there. Nice. I've got an hour until the end of the day! Come on! Fuck me! I can't use my plague thing anymore for some reason. I can't use it. Now I've left the plague district. Great. Do you think they'd be at Isidore's place? Maybe they're at Isidore's place. That seems to be kind of like the focus of a lot of the disease. Oh, shit. Punching another person. Good job, guards. No. Where are the butchers? This is the right district, right? The Skinner's district is contaminated. It must be here, right? Because this is where the map says the contamination is. This must be the Skinner's district, right? Please tell me this is. If I'm in the wrong neighborhood, I'm going to be so sad. But if the map is to be believed, then it would have to be here. Right? Am I majorly missing something? I'm getting awfully nervous. Oh, fuck! Fuck! All I'm doing here is getting myself killed, running around like a jackass. I can just scoot on by, right? Yeah. How's my immunity? Bad. I'm awfully close to death now. Because those pills hurt your heart. Yeah, these directions about where to meet the butchers are slightly vague. Where in the fuck? Don't come towards me. There's a cloud right there, right? I don't get it. Why can't I find these people? The Skinner's district is contaminated. I hope that one of the three butchers at Aspity Dispatch there is able to return the suitable specimen. There's no time to procrastinate. I am supposed to meet them here, right? Didn't she say to go here? Or am I supposed to come back to her? It says there's no time to procrastinate. I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to go here. There's like 15 minutes left in the day. There's no way this is gonna happen. Guard, can you beat up that rat, please? Fine. I'll shoot it. Thanks for the help, buddy. Have you seen the people? No? Oh, you can barter? Price 10. Wait, 10? Oh, that's not money. That's tradable items. Oh, so the guards. You can get food from the guards. I was complaining about the fact that you can't get food from kids, but it looks like there is somebody you can actually trade stuff for. 10's awfully expensive, though. Awfully expensive. It might be cheaper just to trade for goods, sell the goods, and then buy food with the money. Anyway. Yeah. I don't know what's happening. I am super confused. I'm gonna go back to Aspity. And the day is gonna end in 5 minutes. And we'll see if I die? If I haven't completed my main goal by the end of the day? I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna have to reload my save.
The night has come. The most pressing endeavors of the day were fulfilled at the expense of several lives of your bound. A mime performance at the theater will feature today's events.
At the expense of several of the bound. That doesn't sound good. Today's quest is gone. So that means I can't even do it anymore, right? I failed? That's a new letter. Hold on, I'm gonna go back to Aspity. Just to be absolutely sure. Because I think I'm going to reload my save game at this point. I don't want to reload my save game to avoid the consequences of my actions, but I just feel like I'm totally lost and like something's wrong and I'm missing something, and I will reload if that's the case.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's like, I just failed it. I never found the pathogen. I don't get it. I don't get it. I missed something. Alright, well, unfortunately this episode is running long. I wanted to finish this before ending the episode, but I just don't know what's going on. I don't know if I misunderstood Aspity's instructions about where to meet them, or if this is not the Skinner District, although it wouldn't make any sense if it wasn't. I don't get it. It's gotta be here that I'm supposed to meet them. This is the only infected place. so I'm missing something. Even if I did actually have to wait an hour, like she said, I should still have found them. Because I was here for an hour and a half. So even if there is like a timer thing where you have to wait a bit of time for them to finish doing their job, I should still have found them. So I don't get it. But I'm going to figure that out in the next episode, hopefully. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.